am the coordinator and director of the Albany State University Summer Music and Art Camp 2022. And we were just about to start our art exhibition, but before we do that, I want to tell you that we had, this camp was lasted about 2 weeks long, and if you don't know anything about the camp, it's broken down into two camps, actually, an art camp and a music camp. And right now we're going to show what the campers have been doing for the last 2 weeks. So I'm going to turn it over to the coordinators of this camp, Dr. Sneed and Professor Mallard. Thank you. This camp is definitely one of the highlights of the year, the summer, for us, because we get to see the development and the transformation of your children in the art world. And I was telling we had a talent show, if you didn't attend it. But I was telling them that when the first day of the camp, you know, your children who come in through the door into the camp aren't really showing us who they really are, you know, because they're, you know, kind of, you know, afraid of everything, afraid of me. I don't know why that is, but or they just are so reserved. And throughout the each day that goes by, they change. They become, in you know, the young men and women that they really are. And so it is our job and our pleasure to, you know, mold those talents that they have, and, you know, let them know that it's okay to express themselves and to be musical, be artists, and just, you know, take it as it comes, I guess. Today is the culmination of these 2 weeks. Did you enjoy the art exhibition?
Yes.
You know, those are. You know, I'm always amazed at what can be made from, and I think this year you're using branches at one time, and yarn and buttons and paint. I mean, it's just amazing. You know, I hope you enjoyed it. And but this site is the music performances. And let me tell you about what we did on this site. We had them creating beats, which you're going to hear right after I finish talking. And then if you follow the program, make sure that you have a program. If you don't have one, let us know. We'll get you one. We have the vocal camp. We also have the strings, the technology, Dr. Baxter, and then she's also going to do percussion, percussion camp. And then we have one really group that I really enjoy is the camp expressions. And also at the end, we're going to have all of the musicians on the stage, and we're going to be creating some great art, musical art. So without further ado, joining us
on the faculty this year was, for the first time, was a young lady who you may or may not be familiar with her. She works at WALB. She's a director of some sort, and she works really late hours at night, but she came and worked with our students to do something that I wish I knew how to do, and that's create beats. And so without further ado, I'd like to introduce Miss Billy Sands.
Hello, everyone. And I'm, as Dr. Trimmons said, first, I want to say thank you to Dr. Trimmons for giving me this opportunity, as this is my first time. And I want to thank, A, the parents. Thank you for letting us borrow your children for 2 weeks. I think they had a lot of fun. Like going from zero to like little to no music production experience to where they are now. Now they have the seeds, and all you have to do is let them grow. So I also want to take the time to thank my fellow teachers and the fellow camp counselors. So without further ado, let me introduce some music. First we have Alexander Chambers. And these kids make this in like maybe 1 or 2 days. So they got it, like they were on it, and I'm so proud of them. Next we have Garrison. Thank you. Savon.
Thank you.
Isaiah is next. Jesse Thomas. We have a counselor. Karen, Justin. Counselor. stop it there, but good job.
My name is Professor Tracy Davis. I am the Assistant Professor of Voice here at Albany State University, and I had the distinct pleasure of working with your young singers for the past 2 weeks. We have done some fundamentals of sound production and breathing and ear training and things of that nature, and I wanted to just give you a little bit of a taste of the things that we've been doing for the last 2 weeks. So we have two selections for you. And the first one, just wanted to let you know that your singers now know two words in another language. They learned Latin this week. And this first piece is called Jubilate Deo by Michael Pretorius. It is the translation is Be Jubilant to God. And we're using this piece for a couple of different things. To learn our ear training, to learn musical sounds, and to use what we call Kerwin hand signs. If you know anything about singing, or if you've heard of the term solfege, these are nonsense words that we help use, that our singers use to help us read music. And the Kerwin hand signs go with these weird words and sounds that we created. If for our parents, if you remember the movie, thank you, Sound of Music. For some reason, it went out of my head. Sound of Music, the doe, a deer, a female deer. These are the solfege syllables that we use. And we use hand signs to go with it. So this is Jubilate Deo. We are a singing vocal group. What better way to end our portion of this concert today? This song is by Reverend Robert Lowry, who is and also arranged by Robert Hugh. And I wanted to just read the words to you for just a moment, just so you can kind of get the idea of the communication that we're trying to go with this piece. And the words are, my life flows on in endless song, above earth's lamentation, I hear the real, though far off hymn that hails a new creation. Above the tumult and the strife, I hear the music ringing. It sounds an echo in my soul. How can I keep from singing?
My life goes on in endless song, above us.
Above the top. soul. How can I keep? How can I keep from singing? How can I keep from singing?
Technology. What we started was learning about notation, so actually putting like notes on a staff. And so I challenged the kids to, you know, at first it was just, hey, this is how you start the program. Just put some notes up there. It doesn't matter where they are. You know, it could be single line, it could be a score, you know, whatever they decided to do. So basically what I'm going to show you, I have some samples. I didn't get everybody, just like Billy was saying, we had some technical difficulties and we lost some scores or we lost some music. And I did have a few people who just didn't want to show what they had, but that's okay. So I just got a few just short little samples. Some of them are like a couple measures, some will be even longer. So I've got a couple. So we're starting with, I kind of mixed up together, Alicia. I'll just have to show them to you. I'll show them to you visually, since it won't let you hear them, so everybody can see what they look like. This is Alicia. Where are you, Alicia? Yeah, she did her beautiful way. And she said she had a single line score that she put together. Okay. Charles, where are you? There you are, Charles. What did I say? I want to hear. Chris? Single line. Dylan, where are you? He did his tapping score. He had some little syncopation in there. Garrison, where are you? Garrison. He got a lot going on here. Even had, you see those lines that go across, those are like slurs, that's like articulation. We got some crescendos, they crescendos. We got some repeat marks in there. So, now Garrison with the down, some fermata. So, he put a lot of extra stuff on his score. Isaiah? There we go, Isaiah. Once again, a lot of syncopated stuff on there. Some slurs he started on, some different key signatures. Justine, where are you? Justine, down there. Justine started putting in some chords and stacking some notes. A little extra. Jesse. That glass elegance. Ryan, where are you?
There you are.
Ryan started dabbling and trying to do a score. He just was a key. That's like a full concert band score. So he's got stuff in different woodwind parts. We've got some brass parts and then finding some percussion. So he started at the beginning of what would have been kind of like a concert band score. That's pretty neat. Caleb, once again, did a big score, okay? He's got like a mixed winds at the top, small wind score, flutes over clarinet tunes, then a brass score. He actually added in, actually, he has an orchestral score because he has violins and things like that. So things he was just adding in. So, neat little orchestral score. Jeremy. Small mid score, saxophone, French horn, trumpet, and trombone. That's the beginning of that. What was it?
Jay
Barry. Thank you so much. There's always one name I can never think of. Thank you. Okay. Alexander did a big super orchestral score. He had a sonata that he was doing. So you can see at the top, I'll pull that up. Wings at the top, brass in the middle, percussion, and strings. Even had like something for the harps going on. So he was big super score that he put together. River, where are you? River. River is a percussionist, so he decided to be a percussionist for him. Okay? So he has symphony at the top, snare drum, we've got like rolls that you have on snare drum, toms, things like that. So with the percussion score, they have like different note heads. That's why you see stuff like X's and things like that. So we have to play around with getting those different things. So dynamics in there as well. So a neat little percussion score to be worked out. Okay. And our last one is 3-1. Mr. Nottage. Did a nice little string score. Two violins, viola, and cello. So a really nice score. Okay? So these are all the score samples. I'm sorry you didn't get to hear them, but I do want you to appreciate that. Because, you know, notating music, a lot of people, you know, create music is great, but we still have, you know, your students are going to school and they're having to read music. Somebody has to create this music to be read. So it's a great skill set to have. And then also you realize there are people who this is what they do for their job. They are the copywriters. They actually just put the music in. So a lot of different career paths that people could have. You could just, I'm the person who inputs the music for all these big companies. So it's a skill set that's great to have. And then if I can do it myself, I don't have to pay somebody else to do it for me if I'm a great artist. So these are just neat little things that they can do, okay? The other thing we did the last week was we played around with this thing called the Splice Beat Maker. So this just dealt with just like drop and play, just making straight ahead beats. So all it has is just like, you know, bass drums, snare drums, hi-hat, different things. And they got to play around with just creating the beat. It wasn't as intense as what they did with Philly, who had all these different loops and stuff. But they got to create their own kind of little drop beats. Now you really get to see how short I am. Here we go. Rain. Where are you, Rain? Yeah, let's see what Rain sounds like. So it's Rain. Ryan. That's you, Ryan. That's you, right, Ryan? Yeah, there we go, Ryan. Here's it. Alexander again. to Martin?
Yeah.
Where are you? These two programs we worked on, they have free versions of these, so they can definitely go on their own computers and play around with that, keep notating stuff, playing with the beats, things like that. That's just the beginning. We're just giving them just a little taste of what's out there. So hopefully they will continue to add to. Okay? I get to do the next part too. I teach percussion. I'm the percussion professor here at Albany State. So I'm gonna bring up our percussionist. Where are we? Percussion, come on up. All right, so for percussion, we did a lot of things over the 2 weeks as far as doing just exercises and getting used to just doing all things percussion or getting used to do the skills that percussionists need to have. So the first thing we're gonna do, we're gonna give you a sample of what's called a wrist movement exercise. A lot of the times students will just do kind of wrist movement things or have learned to do accents or how to move their hands. So this is just an exercise where different hands are playing different accents. Okay. Learning how to, not everything has to be loud the whole time. You know, some things should be loud, some things should not. Okay? So we're going to do the wrist movement exercise. You ready, guys? Ready? We're on our pads. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. An example where we're all playing the same thing, but in the percussion section, it's like, almost like the percussionists are like soloists within themselves. Everybody plays something different, so you can't rely on your neighbor to play the same thing with you. So we had to practice everybody having a different part, and you've got to read your own part and be able to come in. Okay, so we're playing a piece called precision percussion. Okay, you'll see we all have different things that we're playing on. So we've got a tambourine, our accessory. We've got snare drum, and we've got the triangle, okay? And sometimes we play together, but a lot of times we're all playing something different, and that's like a reading style that sometimes we're not used to because we have a whole section, and we all play the same thing, so they have to be really strong readers to be comfortable to play at different times. All right, Ray, you're like the soloist. You're gonna start us off. 1, 2, and 1, 2, ready, and... Thank you. course, you know, we're the professionals, so we can't not play something groovy. That's what we do. So the last piece we're playing for you is a piece called Quasi Bossa Nova. Everybody know what a bossa nova is? Kind of groovy pieces. It's based off of that. And once again, we all have kind of different parts, okay? Like River is playing a snare drum part. Urian is going to be playing the bass drum, so he's like holding down what we're going to build on top of. Ray is playing our tenor drum part. I'm going to double the other snare drum part, but to give it a little bit of flavor, I'm going to play it on the tambourine so you have some different sounds, okay? This is Quasi Bossa Nova. Ready to hear that? One, two, ready, and. Let me borrow your percussionist.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is the middle school. I call them players. So I think every time we do this, the middle school expression is going to be the players. And, you know, they're the young ones in the camp. However, they have a lot of energy, a lot of personality, and expressions is a camp that I started because music is so is filled with emotion, and it doesn't come naturally for everybody. In fact, it doesn't come naturally for most people, because if you're put on the spot to do something, you would the deer in the headlight look, you know, you'd freeze up. So my goal for this camp was to kind of let them connect to their emotional side, their expressions. So we're going to do this tune called "In a Mellow Tone" by Duke Ellington.
In a mellow tone.
these are the high school singers, and they're going to be performing Bye Bye Blackbird. A few minutes, and I think I'm going to sleep for 2 weeks. But it's been a great time, and once again, thank you all for letting us borrow your children for 2 weeks, and I'm sure that you appreciate it. but we appreciate you all being here. We appreciate them for being here and letting us teach you a few things, and. No, I couldn't do it by myself. So I like to recognize all of our the faculty that helped, that actually carried this camp. And I'm sure I've got it here, yeah. So I'm making mistakes. Our art side, our art camp,
two individuals who are in themselves incredible artists. And Dr. Shavika Sneed, and Dr. Professor Michael Mallard, is he here? He had to step out too. Anyway, thank you all for helping. And the music camp was Dr. Claire Hillard, the strings, Dr. Baxter, Professor Tracy Davis, and Professor Eartha Watkins, which you're going to meet if you don't already know her right now. And with our counselors, these are the ones that probably spent more time with your kids than we did, you know, walking them to the calf, and at 3 o'clock most days, we let them have fun. And a couple of days, I joined in the fun with them, and the next day, I could barely walk. Four corners, it got me, but I love it. But our counselors, Maquan Beasley and Desmond Ham. Here's the swing. Justin Clements. Janice Burnett. Ashley Bonner. Kenneth Wright, Amber Blessing, and Keenan Brown. And if you notice that most of the counselors, all the counselors were an integral part in the music as well. So they'll be performing on piano or trumpet. That's Maquan. What are they doing? Let me introduce my immediate boss, the chair of the Arts and Humanities College, the College of Arts and Humanities, Dr. Marsha Hoods, right here. So without further ado, let me introduce Ms. Eartha Watkins. You probably know her from her public school band directing jobs here in town. I'm sure you taught some of these kids. You taught some of these kids up here?
Yes.
Yes, you did. Some of these people up here?
Yes.
So, ladies and gentlemen, Eartha Watkins and the Wendats.
Thank you. I am going to call on my experience at this time because I'm on the spot here, but I'm okay being on the spot. But I do want to commend our students on the fine job that they've done this week, because it's interesting when you can see them day one and see how they've progressed throughout the week. And so we have worked on several songs here or pieces here to play for you today. And the good thing about it, most of you will probably recognize some of these pieces that we play for you today. So we are going to start off, they probably don't even know what the first song, do y'all know what the first song is? Tempest, all right, so we're gonna start off with the Tempest. And we have a variety of music that we're going to do. Very age appropriate for our students here. And it also gave us a chance to emphasize some things that we needed to work on as well. So they will be performing, first of all, the Tempest, which was a very popular piece written by Robert W. Smith. And then Salvation is Created, which is our most challenging piece, simply because this piece stretched the students. Some of them had to work on some things that they may not have worked on before, and so they had to stretch and play that and make it all happen. And we're working with a limited group as well, so there's a little bit difference in the texture and sound that you'll hear as well. And then we're going to finish up with a piece made popular by the infamous John Williams entitled Star Wars. Okay, so here we go, The Tempest.
Challenge for our students here is we've been talking about playing with emotion, playing with feeling, making something happen with the music, right? A lot harder to do than what you think. So we will perform for you now, Salvation is Created. Thank you.
finish up with something fun and familiar.
Star Wars.
Summer Music and Art Camp 2022.
All right.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for sharing your children with us. And, hopefully we can do this again next year and get bigger and bigger and a larger stage and auditorium, if possible. Now, you may be receiving a survey through the email within the next week or two. So please, tell us how you like it. Tell us the things that we can improve, and we'll definitely implement those things where we can. So thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for your patience, your time, and have a great weekend. Thank you.